Well, hello, Darkfish Rally friends. It's lunchtime here at Rally Estonia. Four stages down. Now, the man who's won all four of those stages is Ott Tänak. But as you probably know by now, he's not the man who leads the rally. But what does Ott Tänak make of his morning out here, the performance of his Ford Puma? Well, I have to say, he didn't agree with my assessment.
I would say it doesn't really show our pure performance for the moment. It's quite clear that we are not really on the level with Toyota and Hyundai. I would say just, you know, because the other guys, they want to finish the rally as well, and they want to win the rally. But, you know, for us, obviously, we are happy. We've been happy end of every stage that we finished, because there's been quite some moments. So it's been not so clean run on that pace.
You know, if we're judging the performance of cars, the best time to judge them is the Friday morning, Luke, because everyone wants to win. Everyone wants to win. So, you know, if we are judging the pace of the M Sport car against the Toyota and the Hyundai, surely it's not that far away. You say it's a little bit to go, but it can't be that much.
I guess a Friday morning has nothing to do. It's the start of the rally, so I would say that your idea is quite wrong.
Well, let's talk about the battle at the top of the field. It is Thierry Neuville that leads the way. Most unusually, Neuville on a Friday morning is normally a little bit of a slow starter, but from his position on the road, he's managed to build a lead. 6.8 seconds, his lead over Kalle Rovanperä. This is what Neuville thought of his morning.
Good. I mean, obviously, times were coming immediately, and we carried on with the same rhythm, good speed. And being in the lead after the first morning loop is a good feeling.
New territory for you, really, isn't it? We don't often see you in this position on Friday lunchtime.
That's true. It depends on the rally, obviously. Also, I'm starting fourth on the road. It's a long time ago. It didn't happen. So this is probably helping a bit this morning. But once again, I feel good in the car as well. And this is giving me a bit more trust.
So a really solid job out there from Hyundai and Neuville this morning. Definitely that car looking way more competitive. But the man that they're all watching is the man who was first on the road. Rovanperä expected it to be difficult out there, but was it maybe a little more difficult than they anticipated?
It was quite dry, a bit more than I was expecting. And like the last one of the loop, when the whole morning was sunny, was quite tricky. The road is drying up and a lot of loose gravel.
Tell me about stage four. You came over a big jump. Had quite a heavy landing. Tell me about that.
Yeah, it's every year a nasty jump. It's not so big, but it's on the fast road and it's a bit like downhill jump. And then on the really high speed, when the aero is pushing the car down, the landing is always really nasty when you are not really straight and you are banging the head around the seat quite a lot.
Yeah, so you know, a great performance from Kalle out there. It wasn't without his incidents, so let's hope he does get a little bit of physio on that neck during the lunch break, and he's back 100% this afternoon. Elvin Evans, well, he lies in third. He's a little bit further behind, 13 odd seconds off the lead. Evans hasn't been enormously comfortable with his performance. He's got a bit to find this afternoon if he hopes to stay in the fight for the win.
Quite low grip, especially in this last one. We felt it quite a lot, but even the previous two, quite loose in places. And it's not been an easy morning.
What are you expecting then for the second pass? A bit cleaner, I would guess, but in terms of approach and setup, maybe a few changes?
Yeah, definitely. Anyway, a few changes needed. But of course, now the afternoon loop will be quite different in terms of condition. We know how rutted it gets here on the second pass, especially with the recent rain. So it's always a bit of a lottery or guess what you find now on the second loop.
So Elvin Evans, yeah, he needs to find something, because you know what? The man who is just behind him in the standings is Esa-Pekka Lappi. And Lappi has gone through the whole morning without hybrid. A kilometre into the opening stage, a heavy landing. And that hybrid box just went, whoop, nope, not for me this morning. So he went the whole of the loop without hybrid. He looks good in that car. He'll have more pace this afternoon. He will threaten Evans's third place, I am sure of that. Further down the field, a quite remarkable start in his Rally 1 debut, Timo Suninen. What a drive from him, 20-odd seconds off the lead, looking comfortable in the car. Decent road position, he made the most of that. But what's really important is the pace, the power, the speed of that car didn't scare him. Suninen looks very much in control out there. A great, great performance from him. further down the field, we've got Katsuta, Pierre-Louis Loubet. Yep, they're battling away there. No real dramas from them. I would call this morning for both Loubet and Katsuta-san confidence-building mornings. They know they've got a little bit more to come in terms of pace, but for both those drivers, it was clean and it was a productive morning out there. What about WRC2? Well, the man who has very much dominated proceedings through the opening four stages is Oliver Solberg.
It's been quite good. times has been not so bad. And then, it's been very fast road, so it's been fun.
You know, you are struggling with a cold a little bit. How much does that affect things? Does it just make it a little bit more difficult physically?
No. When you put your helmet on, you're always focused. Then it's okay. But you notice it more after the stage. And Elliot also noticing on my breathing in the car that I'm breathing more because I have a fever and a cold. So you sweat a lot.
So there we are, folks. A really, really fascinating opening morning here in Estonia. Plenty more to come this afternoon. Little bit of weather around as well. There always is at this time of year in Estonia. Might that just add a little bit of extra intrigue to this afternoon's proceedings? I'm sure it will. Don't forget, if you miss anything this afternoon, Dirtfish Live Centre, press that button there and you can read all of the news, all of the action. You can catch up with all of the drama through this afternoon's stages here at Rally Estonia.